Now I'm in trouble. Because I've shared with you some ideas about place, event, and relationship. I've given you a number of examples, but some of my examples do not necessarily match my full organic metaphor. My fable of the two cows clips along at a nice bright pace. It goes very succinctly and simply through, which is common in fables and folk tales. There's not this elaborate, nostalgic, indulgent time of placing that I used in my earlier story. It gets right to the point. There were once two cows, they did this, that, and the other thing, and this is the end of the story. That seems in some ways to contradict what I've been suggesting earlier. But let's look at that and think about it in this way. You have not just grown a flower, you've grown an entire garden. It's all stretching out there in your beautiful backyard. Now what you want to do is to create a garden path so that people who come into that garden, the friends that you tour through that garden, will have different ways to explore it. Let us think now of a story, not as a single flower, but as an entire landscape. There are many different directions that you can go, many different places that you can visit. You can take a short hike through that landscape, or you can take the scenic route. These are all of your options, all of them available to you. But the story is still the story, no matter how much of it you visit. When we are in school, at the very same time that we are being taught about beginning, middle, and end, there's another lesson that you will remember. The shortest distance between two points is a straight line. That may be true that the shortest distance between two points is a straight line, but it somehow is implied that the best distance between two points is a straight line. And indeed, there are times when a straight line is the best distance between two points. When I want to get to my point quickly and directly and succinctly, as when I tell a fable. If I want to go out to the garden, I want to get right to the rose bushes because I want to see that award-winning rose. I want a straight line to it. But if I want a fuller, richer experience, sometimes a straight line is not the best way between two points. Sometimes the best distance between two points is a wavy, meandering, wandering line. The storyteller has the choice, a straight line, a slightly curving line, or a wildly wandering line. But you only have that choice if you know your landscape, if you can see that story not as a prepared script, as a mechanical text with specific parts that have to fall in place each and every time exactly and precisely, but as a rich world of possibilities that you can explore, depending on your purpose and your listener. Now, if my listener is, say, an office mate, and I need to give my office mate a story to explain an idea that imparts a message, my office mate may be very busy and may not be willing to sit through a long, meandering, and exhausting narrative. That's a point at which the straight line is important. A quick, direct, succinct memo. That's where straight lines are useful. If I'm designing a superhighway to speed traffic along out of the inner city into the suburbs, I want as many straight lines as possible. If I'm designing a country road for vacationers to absorb the landscape and to visit interesting and out-of-the-way places, I definitely want a meandering line. And it's that way for the storyteller. If you've got some time, then maybe I'll tell you about the two cows. Maybe I'll give them a name. Let's call them one Mabel and one Clara. And one day Mabel said to Clara, Clara, do you ever wonder, is there anything more to life than this little muddy patch with these brown strands of tired grass? And Clara, chewing slowly her cud, rolled her brown eyes, looking at Mabel, and said, maybe. Now I'm starting to take the meandering path through my story. So you see, we can use this organic metaphor in a number of ways. We can look at the individual story as growing the way a single flower grows up from a seed. We can also look at the story as a landscape that we as storytellers are guiding our listeners through. So the storytelling experience has the feeling of a journey. And it's that journey that makes the story worth the telling. So that when at last we have arrived at that point of the conclusion of our story, of the completion and the fulfillment of our journey, we all have a wonderful blossoming moment in which we are relating together. And so there are a number of ideas that we can find useful for us as storytellers and story growers from this organic metaphor. To review, place, event, relationship, tending to and nurturing forth rather than making and constructing. These organic ideas have a variety of uses, and perhaps are especially useful if we think of what we want to accomplish as storytellers as imparting an experience to our listener, giving them a kind of virtual reality, giving them a set of images rich with sensual elements and ideas that they will have a feeling for, then that organic approach is extremely useful. It's also useful for certain kinds of stories that we may want to tell. I think perhaps especially useful for the personal story. If I'm going to tell you something about myself, I want you to have some feeling for me, who I am, where I'm from. And so I can take my time and I can piece together a variety of experiences to make this kind of garden, if you will, of my story.